everyone. Does splitting a quadratic expression into two linear factors gives you a pain in the neck? Well, not anymore, kyunki main hoon na. I am here with my super shortcut, which is the magic cross. Well, before I begin, a couple of things. First of all, this method I am going to apply only to the questions which could be split into proper linear factors. Secondly, when you start applying this method, make sure you practice at least 10 to 15 questions in a go, because that would make you super confident. You would get the knack of it, and phir ban jayega ye aapke liye bachcho ka khel. So let the magic begin. So let's try the technique, and you would trust me, solve it under 5 seconds. When you come across a question, so what we are going to do is, first of all, look at the coefficient of x square and write it into the factors, any two factors. Here it's very simple, let's say 1 and 3. What I usually do is the smaller factor I put on the top and the bigger one below. Now, same way you are going to split this. So I can do it as maybe 3 into 5. Now, whether you have to write 3 into 5 or 5 into 3, that will come with experience. Most of the times, whatever is a smaller factor comes on the top and the bigger one at the bottom. But at times, you might have to switch. Secondly, at times, if a number has many more factors, which one would fit would actually come by more and more practice and more experience. So once you do that, let's apply the magic cross, which is you cross multiply these. Keep in mind, here you had x. So when you cross multiply, this becomes 9x. When you cross multiply, this becomes 5x. Now just check out what is the sign you require overall. You need plus here and minus here. The same signs come over here, and your factor is x plus 3 and 3x minus 5. Whoa, wasn't that super simple? Have a look. Going with the same magic, now when it comes to 18, you could have choices like expressing it as 1 into 18, 18 into 1, 2 into 9, 3 into 6, all those things, just like you prime factorize. Well, out of experience, I feel it should be best working with 3 into 6. And here, your 35 is quite simple. It would be 5 into 7. So, once I do that, now, if I cross multiply, this one gives me 30x, this one gives me 21x. You know the sign is positive, so plus should come with the bigger number and minus with the smaller. The answer is 3x plus 5 into 6x minus 7. Bingo! I am sure it took less than 5 seconds. Have a look. So many of you keep asking me for a lot of videos which are already on my channel. So would request you to go on the playlist section of my channel, and you could see a lot of videos which are not only math shortcuts but your full concept videos for class 11th and 12th. And of course, you're more than welcome to request any video. You never know which one is the next one. So continue watching. Now with the next one, again you can have a lot of choices with 12. 1 into 12, 2 into 6, 3 into 4. With experience, trust me, it comes across straight that okay, I can try this factor and it would work very well. So like here, I would like to try 3x and 4x. And for 35, it's simple, 5 into 7. Now, if I cross multiply, this one gives me 21x, and if I cross multiply, I get a 20x over here. Now, you need the overall negative sign, so that means the bigger factor would be negative and the smaller one would be positive. Bingo, you've nailed it. So the answer is 3x plus 5 and 4x minus 7. Wasn't this super simple? Have a look.
Congratulations, guys. Keep it up.
Now for the next question. If I have 24 and I try expressing it as, let's say, 3x into 8x, and this one 21. So if I try writing 3 into 7, you would realize this is 21 and this is 24. Even if I try to add it up, it would not give me 65. And if I try to switch this, what happens now? If I multiply, it is 56x. And if I multiply this, this is 9x. You know, if you add these two numbers, you are going to get your magic factors. So also it has negative sign. That means I need negative sign with both of them. Well, then the answer is 3x minus 7 and 8x minus 3. I am sure you wouldn't have even dreamt of solving these quadratics so quickly. Have a look, and then I have more questions for you. Now, look at the fifth question. Again, I can split my 14 as 2x into 7x. Coming to 15, if I try putting 3 into 5, what happens is this is 10x and this is 21x. It will not give me 41. It will give me 31. And if I try switching these, I would have 6x from here and I would have 35x with here. Bingo! I have cracked it and I need a positive sign, so I know my factor would have plus. So the answer is 2x plus 5 and 7x plus 3. Tell me it was very easy. If you look at question 6, it looks very intimidating. But trust me, it is not very difficult. First thing you should do is try to take anything common if you can find a common factor, because that is going to make your calculations very simple. As it is, you realize it's a cubic equation and not a quadratic. So that means you will have to take 5x common. This becomes 7x squared, this becomes minus 21, and this would become minus 46x. Let's rearrange, because we are only interested in this. So 7x squared minus 46x minus 21 becomes the quadratic expression I want to crack. Now here, I can write it as x into 7x. For 21, it's again simple. It's 3 into 7. We just have to see whether it would work with 3 into 7 or 7 into 3. What I feel, it would work with 7 into 3. For the reason, when I multiply, this becomes 49x and this becomes 3x. Now, you need the negative sign. So that means it comes with a bigger number and plus with a smaller. So x minus 7, 7x plus 3. And the final answer, you attach 5x with it. Wasn't this so simple? Have a look. It's time to do something on your own. Yes, do it yourself. I'm sure by the time I'm actually telling you this, more than half of you have already started solving. Oh, and maybe would have finished by now. Well, comment your answers fast, as you know the top 3 answers get named in my upcoming videos. So, I have no doubts about it that you guys really enjoyed this method. Yes, then make this video a big success. Give it a big thumbs up. Share it with all the people. All the people means even the ones who are in grade 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, or you know, you have reached your graduation, post-grad, because this is something which has been bothering each one of you. And if you haven't done that so far, make sure to subscribe to my channel for many more math videos. Do not forget to check out the various playlists on my channel. I make not only the shortcuts but also the full concept videos. I would see you with the next video very, very soon. Until then, bye-bye.